windmill. Windmills were apparently widespread in Persia even before the advent of Islam, and the knowledge of them also reached other parts of the Islamic world quite early. In 8th century Hegira, 14th century AD, the geographer Samsuddin Muhammad ad-Dimaski gave the most detailed description of a windmill together with an illustration. They erect a building as high as a minaret, or they take a high mountaintop, or a similar hill, or a castle tower. On these, they construct one room above the other. In the upper room, there is the mill that turns and grinds. In the lower one, there is a wheel that is turned by the wind, which has been harnessed. When the wheel below is turning, the mill on the wheel above turns. No matter what kind of wind blows, those mills turn. When they have carried out the construction of the two rooms, they make four embrasures in the lower room, like the embrasures in the walls. Only here, the embrasures are the other way around, as their broad part is turned to the outside and their narrow part to the inside, thus forming a channel for the air, so that through it the air enters inside with force as in the goldsmith's bellows.